Sup, Rotten? If you bought a Mac with Apple Silicon, an M1, M2, or even an M3, you were promised speed, silence, and a long-lasting battery. But now, some time has passed, and your Mac just doesn't have that snap like it used to when you took it out of the box. Apps are lagging, and maybe you're seeing the Beats ball more often than you'd like. And now you're starting to wonder, is there a conspiracy at play? Was this part of Apple's plan all along? Is Apple Silicon already slowing down? Spoiler! Yes, but not for the reasons you think. Today, we're breaking down why even the fastest Mac can start to feel slow over time, and what's actually causing it, and how to fix it natively on your Mac to get it up and running optimally again. Some things you may know, some you may not, but I know one thing for sure is that some of these tips are bound to help. And if they do, be sure to hit that subscribe button for more sick tips from your favorite Apple. Let's get into it. Okay, let's be real. You haven't restarted your Mac And while some of you may think it's fine, because your Mac isn't showing any real issues due to its efficiency, there could be quite a few quirks that could prevent your Mac from running at its full optimal performance. So, restart. Yeah, it's really that simple. Some apps can leak memory after a while, sucking up more of your precious resources in order to keep it stable. Restarting improves security, resolves problems, improves performance, recovers space on your drive, and keeps your Mac up to date with updates. If you can't remember when you last restarted it, do it for good measure. Your Mac will reward you by performing the best it possibly can. And it's simple. All you have to do is click the Apple icon and click restart. Takes 1, maybe 2 minutes of your time. Come on, you can afford that. I would advise doing it like twice a month, personally. I know some of you minimize your apps. Out of mind, out of sight, right? Well, unlike you, your Mac doesn't have object permanence. Chrome is in the background, still eating at your RAM like it's Thanksgiving leftovers. As well as just having a bunch of them up and running can be very demanding for your Mac. It would be best to quit apps that you're not using or don't plan to use soon to prevent any problems in the future. To do that, press Command Tab to see your active apps, and while holding Command, you can cycle through your active apps by repeatedly pressing Tab. Once you reach the app you want to close, press Q. For the nerds out there who want to go more in depth, hit Command Space to open up your respective Mac search tool and open Activity Monitor. There, you'll see more information. Now there's no excuse. I better not see any white dots under anyone's apps in the docs that they're not using, okay? Quit those apps, all right? You don't need those apps open at all times, all right? Don't make me come over there. I have some sad news to report. Your lack of cleanliness is, in fact, negatively affecting your Mac. Take a second and look at that desktop of yours. Cluttered, messy, embarrassing, and your Mac thinks so too. In fact, your Mac thinks it's so messy that it refuses to run at its optimal performance because of it. It's a little sassy, I know. Every icon on your Mac is treated as a previewed image. That clutter, it's costing you. I would suggest cleaning it up or press right-click, use stacks. Or, you know, don't use your desktop for much at all. I know it may be crazy to some of you, but it does wonders for both your mind and your Mac if you manage to clear your desktop of those files. And don't get me started on the corrupted ones, because if you ever had a file suddenly stop working on you, this is something you're gonna want to know about. You open a photo or video you really need. Maybe it's a client project, a recording, something from your camera roll, and instead of loading, it just glitches, crashes, or tells you it's corrupted. And just like that, hours of work or memories are gone. That's where Wondershare Repair It comes in. It's a smart and simple tool designed to fix broken or corrupted files. Things like photos, videos, PDFs, Word docs, PowerPoints, you name it. You literally just drag in the damaged file, let Repair It scan and rebuild it, and boom, it can recover and repair it like nothing ever happened. It even lets you preview the result before saving it, which is a nice touch. And this works across both Windows and Mac, even with its high-res videos, including 4K and above. If you work with a lot of media or documents, or just have a bunch of old files you can't open anymore, this is a no-brainer. There's a link in the description below where you can check it out, and big thanks to Wondershare for sponsoring this video. Having a lot of apps is great, believe me, but it can really be a pain if you're not paying attention. Many apps do this pesky thing called open at login, where whenever you boot up or restart your Mac, those apps with this feature enabled will boot up along with it. Pretty convenient, right? Unless a bunch of apps are using this feature at once, sucking up your Mac's resources and immediately slowing it down before you even get to start using it again. That's right. Some of you are launching 12 apps every time your Mac wakes up. Go to System Settings, General, Login Items. Turn off those apps you know you don't need to boot up every time. I would suggest only picking your favorite ones, as the other ones you can just open manually whenever you need them, no problem. Also, there's some apps that might not show up in the system settings, so you might have to go into the settings of the individual app to disable it. Just letting you know. Some of these apps are sneaky, man. They're like pets. You gotta keep them in check sometimes. Now this one may put some of you on blast, but hey, someone has to say it. You have to keep your Mac up to date. As time passes, your outdated Mac may struggle with the modern demands that the apps you use every day may require, which can suck up unnecessary resources from your Mac to keep up and running, or just flat out cause your apps to work improperly. Not to mention, not only could your performance improve, but also your security. Save future you a headache by keeping your Mac up to date. On the top left, choose Apple Menu, System Settings. Click General on the left side, and then click Software Update on the right side. And your Mac will tell you if it's updated or not. If it's not, download the update and then install. It'll probably take a while, but it's worth it. I know your Mac been reminding you, you've just been ignoring it, huh? Don't let it happen again. Now, imagine you're standing in a pool of water that goes all the way up to your neck. You may be almost submerged, but you're fine as long as your head is above the water. Your Mac storage is sort of the same. Around 10 to 15% of your Mac storage is the head in the scenario. You should always leave that amount of storage free in order for your Mac to properly breathe. Overloading your Mac's drive can significantly hinder its performance if you don't keep this in mind. Reducing this load by cleaning up old and larger files can really go a long way, so I would advise taking a gander at what's hogging up your storage. Go to Apple Menu and click System Settings. Click on General, then go to Storage. In the Storage section, you'll find all the information you would need, as well as recommendations on managing your storage efficiently. Here's a bonus too. Just because you deleted those pesky files doesn't mean they're gone for good yet. Be sure to empty that trash can as well, as it will hold those files for at least a month if you don't do anything about it. This feels obvious, I know, but most people just leave it there chilling. Now go ahead and take care of that. Your Mac isn't slow because it's old. It's slow because you treated it like a tech junk drawer. But now, you've cleaned house, cleaned out the RAM hogs, and probably learned a setting or two you didn't even know existed. Try these steps, then come back and tell me if your Mac is moving again like it did when you first got it. Any more tips I may have missed? Let me know in the comments. And if you would like early access to Ryan Apple videos long before the public gets to see them, or even a little custom avatar to go along with your name, feel free to support me on Patreon along with my Ryan and Ryan Pro subscribers, Vasco, Franz Kobach, Sour Kiri, Daniel, Clacius, Carbon Ranger, and Miss Game. Thank you all for the support, as it keeps me dropping videos consistently, and thank you viewers for watching. If you want to see more of me, you know what to do. I'm gonna be honest, the main reason why I made this video is because I'm the token tech friend in my friends and family groups, and instead of troubleshooting with them every single time, I can just send them this video. So yeah, this one was a little bit more selfish on my part, but it had to be done.